What's up, Channel Fireball YouTube? Welcome to another draft video here of Zendikar Rising. Before we dive into our pack one, pick one in this best of one queue, just want to go ahead and remind everybody that this video is brought to you by Channel Fireball, in particular U-Box WeBuy, which is the easiest way to sell your Magic cards. Throw them in a box, CFB does the sorting, the grading, the pricing, you get your cash fast and easy. So just head on over to channelfireball.com/uboxwebuy or click the link in the description for more info. And be sure to use the code Lord Tupperware when you check out to let them know I sent you. All right, pack one, pick one here. I do believe Inscription of Abundance is one of the few reasons to dip into green early in a draft in this format. Generally, I'm looking to backdoor into green decks, but Inscription of Abundance is absolutely busted, especially in conjunction with either Marasa Sproutling to get it back or Tazim Royal Mage right here to get it back. So both of those, I think, so I think this is a great option. If this weren't here, then it's sort of interesting. I think Blade Master is a real reason to draft Red-White Warriors, Relic Amulet, a real reason to draft Blue-Red Wizards, but I will just start off with my Inscription. And you can sort of see why I'm not super thrilled about starting off with a green card here what's the play here, right? I'm not taking any of these three cards at the bottom. I think it comes down to Feed the Swarm versus Malakir Rebirth, which already is making me feel not great about diving in, because I don't think black-green is a very good deck, but you know, black-green, MDFC value, I think, is a good spot to be in sometimes, if you can get some Kazandu Stompers to pick up your MDFCs. So that's going to lead me to take Rebirth over Feed the Swarm here, even though Feed the Swarm is a card I like very much. All right, and more green cards that are not exciting. More cards, period, that are not really exciting. You know, I think a lot of folks are a big fan of Cinderclasm. I am not one of those people. This card, I think, is totally fine. It's not a card I'm looking to main deck, so best of one, that means it's out. There's a Grotag Nightrunner if we were trying to party, which we don't know that we are. There's a red-white dual land, not really helpful for us. Skyclave Pickaxe if we wanted to be aggressive, which we could be, given the Inscription. And then the other option, I think, is Blood Beckoning. That's probably the best card, and also a good card in, I think, specifically black-green. I mean, I think it's just good everywhere, but specifically in black-green, I think there are versions of that deck that are just caring to be, you know, grindy, value, 2-for-1, etc. So I'm going to take Blood Beckoning very early in my mind to take it here, but don't really want to dip into another color just yet. But I will dip into another color for Into the Royal. So we could have taken a Seafloor Stalker out of that last pack. That was the other, you know, another card that was in consideration there for me. But I think it's better just to stick with black there. We take Into the Royal here. We still have outs to do a number of things. Could still be blue-green kicker. I mean, I would really like to play Inscription, but if green is not open, I'm not going to force my way into green for this card. I just, like, green is just too junky for you to want to draft it when it's not open, and it seems to be not very open. Second Into the Royal is great here. This, I think, is too late for this card, as it's probably certainly the best blue common in my mind, and I'm probably the second best common overall. So to have a rare, an uncommon, and two commons taken over it feels quite wrong to me. So snap that up there. Keeping on the blue train, we could just take Expedition Diviner. Sticking with black, nothing really appealing there. Dipping into another color doesn't seem that prudent at this moment, so I'll take the Diviner here. And I guess Arisen Riptide is fine, though this card has fallen quite a bit in my estimation in terms of when I want it, but when I want it is when I have multiple Into the Royals, because then I feel like I have flexibility. The problem with this card, I find, is that if you don't have any ways to enable kicker on your opponent's turn, it's not a great blocker, right? You can't, like, ever blow them out, but Into the Royal really can. So we'll take the Riptide there. Wow. Okay. And we get a Royal Mage along with a Seafloor Stalker. Both of these would be great picks here. I think are probably a little too late. Stalker, maybe not. Definitely too late for a Royal Mage in my mind. And we get it. I was wondering if we were going to get that Royal Mage on the wheel, and we do. So we're in a great spot here in terms of knowing that blue is open and having some great blue cards at our fingertips, and then it's just going to be a matter of figuring out what pairs best with that blue. I'll take a Nectar Pot. We passed basically no green, right? There was a Dauntless Survivor in this pack, along with these two green commons. So we passed basically no green. So I would assume that green could be open from the left, in which case that would be great because I get to play my Inscription. Nectar Pot's a card that I think is totally fine, serviceable, medium kind of card in terms of if you're a defensive deck, which we very, very well could be. I think I'll take a Zendikon over the third Nectar Pot. Perhaps there just wasn't very much good green open. I mean, it might have Marasa late as well is pretty nice. And I think Orn Reef Ooze is gonna be a second reason for me to try and stick with this green. I'm gonna check it on the curve. I know this view isn't great during the draft, but just wanna check in on our curve here. I think we could probably pitch the Nectar Pots for now, but the rest of our deck looks like a lean, mean kicker machine. Plus one, plus one counter synergies only with a potential kick to Sentinel and Inscription at the moment, but Orn Reef Ooze is just good on its own, I think. It just spirals out of control pretty quickly. And not passing. I mean, Chilling Trap, not really a blue signal in my mind. And, you know, calling the ambush is great. And then a couple green chonkers here at the top. But happy to grab this Orn Reef Ooze and try and see if green can't be open from the left. So now we have the option of Bubble Snare versus Tangled Florahedron. Pretty tempted by the Florahedron. I think I like this card more than most. And these kicker decks are often quite mana hungry. You know, we're going to want to get to six pretty consistently. And part of the reason I like taking the Florahedron here, even though I think Bubble Snare might be better, is one, it's an MDFC, so it's just quite powerful in and of itself. But then we're very likely with how open blue was to wheel, you know, if we assume someone else snaps up a Bubble Snare, any of these three, really, I'd be happy to play in our deck. So I'm going to take the Florahedron for that reason. And now no blue cards, which is weird because we didn't pass very much blue, but we've got Horn Beetle, Stomper, Bite, and Reclaim the Wastes. I mean, I'm generally excited about Reclaim in these decks. Let me see, how do our creatures punch? Not very well. They don't punch very well, though. If we're in blue-green, like how do we get stuff off the board, I think is Rabid Bite, but I think Reclaim is just better, especially for kicker purposes. And for potential splash purposes, I think I like that there. All right, Geyser Mage is great as well. And let's just be clear that our only thing that cares currently about kicker is the Riptide, though I expect we'll wheel that other Riptide from the first pack as well. So we'll take Geyser Mage here pretty happily. Wow, a Lotus Cobra, so late. I mean, Gnarled Colony is great too in terms of kicker, but I think, again, thinking about what the deck wants to do and how mana hungry I think it will be, and then now we have Cobra and Reclaim as possible splash outlets. I'm gonna take Cobra. Plus it's gems, you know, can't pass up those gems. Field Research, again, mana hungry, just what the doctor ordered for this deck, I think. And we get a Gnarled Colony anyway over here. This is awesome. Everything is coming up Millhouse right now for us in this draft. Our curve is great. Our synergy is pretty darn good. Would like more MDFCs. I think we are currently in the market for more Riptides. I guess Inscription also gets things off the battlefield for good. Yeah, I would say we're in a really good spot. I think Diviner is looking currently out of place, though double Royal Mage and Geyser Mage is probably enough to get that party going or keep that party going. Nothing here for us. Just take the Kazul's Fury. Unlikely that we play it. And this was our first, or the next pack had all the blue cards. I think Ascetic is fine. I think we're on track to not need it in terms of our playable count. Yeah, second Riptide does wheel, which is good. I was expecting three of the four blue cards to be here, so that means there are two other blue drafters at the table, which could be trouble for us in pack three, considering green didn't seem very open. But again, that might have just been a product of there not being a lot of green opened at the table, period. We already have one Might. Three drop slots pretty stacked, but I don't anticipate wanting a second one of those. I guess if we get like Roost, then I'll just want anything that says kicker on it, basically. Wow. Okay, green is open. Never mind. Yeah, that's pretty crazy. So I think there just wasn't good green open at the table. All right, so Here I'm going to take Arbor Mage and hope to wheel the third Riptide. I do think Riptide is looking very good in this deck. I think Diviner's not going to make the cut at this point. And Stomper might not make the cut either. I think this Riptide's going to be great. But Arbor Mage just wins games. And I think our deck is pretty well set up to have it be a just wins games type of deal. And yeah, hello Nahiri. Hello 40 gems, but we're going to ship that. And hope the Riptide comes around. Won't be that bummed if it doesn't. Pretty bummed about this pack. So we could take a Royal Eruption on the splash, which I don't hate considering we have Reclaim and Lotus Cobra. And the other option is Rabid Bite. And like I said, I don't think our creatures bite very well, unfortunately. I mean, I guess our Gnarled Colonies can. This is close for me. I think I currently don't want to mess with the mana. It's so tough, because if we had a second Reclaim, this would be an easy Eruption in my mind. I'm going to take it. I might get greedy here. And we get to see, we get the best of both worlds here in some sense. I mean, we could take Bite. I'm going to take Jorari Disruption out of this pack as a second MDFC, and one that I like, I think, more than most. Yeah, we'll pick that up. Solundi Vision versus Lull Mage is familiar, which I really want in this deck, actually. I mean, I don't think this is like an important piece generally, but I think for how mana hungry we are, this is going to be great. This is also going to gain us quite a bit of life. All right, familiar, that is. Wow, Glass Pool Mimic and a third into the Royal. Is it crazy to take Royal here? I don't have a ton of great copies, right? Like copying a Gnarled Colony isn't great. It's basically just like Ooze, Familiar. I think I'm taking Royal. What's our creature count at? 14? Yeah, we're good. I'm going to take Royal. That's kind of crazy. if you had told me. All right, another Colony's good here. Yeah, this deck is just really cooking. So there's a Moss Pit Skeleton, Seafloor Stalker, Colony number 4. Huh. Probably just Colony number 4, right? More Kicker equals more better, especially if we're going to get that third Riptide. Wow, a Lull Mage's Domination too. That's beautiful. That's a beautiful sight right there. Ugh, we did not wheel the other Riptide. All right. Well, we tried. That's fine. I think that'll be fine. Not playing anything here. I can see wanting Broken Wings. I doubt it, though. We're just so tempo-oriented. Gotta make at least a cut. And it might just be that this Royal Eruption splash is too dicey. And then we do that, and that's 15 basics plus 2 MDFCs plus Reclaim, which I think I'm okay with. And plus Cobra and Familiar. Yeah, so we could have had a Rabid Bite over the Eruption. And again, I'm not even sure how good Rabid Bite is in our deck, period. Like, this Stomper is looking kind of out of place. Maybe Diviner is just better than Stomper? That's probably not true. Probably not true. God, Domination with 2 Royal Mages is so good. And this is how it's done, folks. Build your deck as you draft, and then we just go probably cut, and we're good. Put these in a 4-drop slot where they belong. Put the MDFCs over here. Put this up probably in like the 5-drop-ish spot. And that's the deck. All right, see you for the round. See if we can't spin up a little bit of Mythic rank here. All right, here we are for game number 1. Our opponent goes first. This will be a keep. It's a little bit on the slow side. We'll see if we have to fire off our Royal Mage on 2, depending on if our opponent's got a 2-drop. We'll probably still play it anyway. Oof. Cleric of Life's Bond. Okay. Yeah, I still think I probably have to play this. just like looking at the makeup of our hand. I wonder what in the rock, paper, scissors life, what clerics versus blue green is about. I feel like clerics has a bit of an edge here. So I'm gonna start with ooze, I think. I think that's that with the end of the royal follow-up seems a little better to me. So I'll do this. No attacks. And then hope that we can get a little tempo game going in our favor with end of the royal into inscription. Definitely blocking here. Seems like a subtle strike. No? Okay. Prowling Felidar. Wow, I don't even have to do the tempo game. That's surprising to me. I still think our play this turn is gonna be into the royal. All right, end turn. Landfall. I don't think I can afford to take six here, so I'm probably bouncing the Felidar. Dwarry Disruption. And Felidar comes back. Single white mana up for our opponent. Attack. Get that counter. And I think we're on. I mean, we could just Riptide Disruption and wait a turn here. I think I'm gonna do that, actually. Because we also get to hold up inscription here if at all necessary, but the idea of inscription next turn as a pretty big attack is very appealing to me. So if it is subtle strike, which I do believe it is, I think we can just take this rather than like set ourselves up to have Riptide get eaten. Maybe they kick a Gloom Hunter here. No, nothing. Wow. Okay. Interesting. So what does this mean? If it's vanquish the weak in response to me, so I could go to try and put two counters here and then fight. This is scary. I think I'm just attacking with ooze then. Take six. Okay. Marauding Blight Priest. All right. Oh, that's pretty awkward, actually. All right, so I think I'm going to... Is there any reason to do this now? No. Resolves. But now I know that... Yeah, I go to four, so now both of these are lethal threats. Block. All right, so target creature gets two counters. You. Target player is gonna gain. Target creature fights target creature. Now, if they have subtle strike, this is bad. But I can't really. Can't really do much about it. and yet they had nothing. So perhaps I played that game too cautiously, but we got the W anyway, 1-0. All right, here we go for game number two. Another very unexciting hand, I would say, but still a keep. Put on Balaged Sanctuary on turn one. Again, probably gonna fire off one of these two. My guess is Royal Mage. Yeah. Red-Green Warriors? Question mark? We'll see. All right, Teeter Peak Ambusher, and now, wow, pretty savage card there. Now no longer can block or attack, at least for now. Into the Royal, great little follow-up there. That gives us a nice Riptide, Royal attack, Gnarled Colony attack. That lets us potentially turn the beat around, though. Red-Green may have some chonkers to respond with here. We'll see. Land number four for the opponent. Rock Slide Sorcerer in red green. Okay. Get in for 1 point of damage here. As they'll make Royal Mage not be able to block, I assume. Yep. And then Riptide blocks the two power creature. And I think I'm just roiling here and smashing for seven. Turning that beat right around. Sorcerer is a little scary with us having an X1 on the board, but not much to be done there. Okay, they play Baloth, attack for three. Looks like no land drop either. Interesting. So what? I guess I go land, attack both? I think I actually just want to do Colony kicked and attack with Riptide. That sets up a pretty nasty potential win with Might of Murasa next turn with our trample. Ooh, we getting bitten? Somebody's getting bitten here, it looks like. And it's the Colony, okay. Wayward Guide Beast, and they're attacking with everybody. I go to three, and then I win. Looks like it. Seems pretty good. And boom goes the dynamite. All right. 2-0. All right, here we go. I get to go first now. I will keep another unexciting hand, but the unexciting hands have been panning out so far. Probably going to lead on Field Research, but if our opponent lands a two here, then I will return with an Arbor Mage. Another Red-Green Warriors, huh? Well, Fishy Whiz. Huh. All right, they pitch a Molten Blast. We'll see if they want to trade. Yeah, I'm happy to trade here. Does Riptide change things? I think so. I think Riptide changes things enough to do that rather than research. There's still like the possibility that we just go land. And that means colony into draw three instead of draw two, which is good. Yeah, I'll eat an Infuriate or a Might of Murasa, if that's what they want to do. Mm-hmm. Sorry, not Infuriate. Inordinate Rage, that's what it's called. Costs two, and it scries. Yeah, that's fine. Ideally, we hit untapped land here. All right, that's going to make me draw. Nice. Royal Mage with Domination is so good. So we'll drop a colony here to use our mana, because I expect we're going to steal something next turn, and then the following turn, get that back, steal something again. Yeah, I block. Canopy Baloth. Okay. What to do? Kind of makes me want to play this kicked. Force them to have a land drop. Give us a little more time to maybe steal something bigger. Leaves us the potential to double spell next turn with Riptide Might. Okay, there's a land drop, so I won't block. Rockslide Sorcerer. This is the same opponent. Okay. Now I'd like to steal that. Like one of these chonkers. And I certainly don't want to play Royal Mage yet. So I think I'm just going to drop Riptide and pass. Yep. So if they have a spell, we get 2-for-1 here, but I don't really see a choice at the moment. Yeah. Or a wizard as a follow-up. But we at least get that off the battlefield. Untapped land to steal the sorcerer next turn would be great. Just great. Wow. And that is just about the worst. So finish off colony. Get back Baloth. So I think that means I'm going to start. 1, 2, 3, 4. Steal that. No attacks. Then we can kick it, get it back, ping the Fisher Wizard, get even attack next turn. I do think Domination is what I want to get back here. Okay, there's Baloth. And you can see what I mean about this deck being very mana hungry. It's just really not difficult for us to tap out each and every turn. This is feeling a little like rabid bite to me. I'm not quite sure what they're thinking about at the moment. Royal Eruption, okay. Just straight up erupt. That's fine. So, Royal Mage, kicked. And I get back Domination. And I think no attack, because it forces them to have a land drop. So I think no attack. Probably should play land there. Whoa. I think we just do this and take six. The reason being is I really don't, we can go to one. I guess no attack still. I guess I shouldn't have played that land now that I have Baloth out. Bug catcher, sure. Oh, that's good. Oh, that's very good. Okay. And we'll attack. Yeah. I feel like I lost my train of thought there about something. Yeah, the magic number I'm thinking of here is being at six is okay, going to five is bad because of a kicked Royal Eruption. And no attacks feels like we got this one now. We'll go hit that land drop. I think now the play is to get back Field Research. Or maybe even Arbor Mage to just win next turn. They have something now, unless they're in full control. I'm gonna get back research. Oh, I didn't have... Oh, I can't get back an Arbor Mage. I can't get back something with Kicker. It's not Sproutling. Okay. I actually think I'm only attacking with Risen Riptide. Again, a reason to not play the land. Maybe playing a little too conservatively. I'm just trying to figure out how I can lose at this point. And it feels like I can lose by, you know, overextending and then not blocking a trampler. And I don't know, then they have might or something. Alright, no attacks. Still holding on to some stuff. So we'll start by kicking it with the Field Research. All Mage is familiar, gaining us those four life is really nice. About to gain us two more, I assume. They have to have a combat trick, is my guess. I'm not sure. I mean, I recognize that I could go for lethal here. Actually, no, I couldn't. No, it would be 11. Yeah. But I think that I'm fine with this, whatever. Because it feels like they have something, and so I'm interested in being able to respond to that something. And if I put them to 2 here, I think that's also pretty darn good. Spike field hazard, sure. I guess I could have bounced it back, but this is also very fine. Nice. 3-0. All right, here we are for game number 4. Our opponent goes first. We'll keep. This will be a really good hand on the play. To get that ooze down. Another red opponent. Bug catcher. Blue red this time. So we'll drop a royal mage, as we are wont to do these days. Followed up with the ooze. Definitely blocking. That's what we came here to do. Again, if this is... Oh, weird. Yeah, totally fine with that. Nice. So we get to drop the ooze, put a counter on itself. Ostensibly, we have blocks here, though I won't block if they attack. Be a pretty great bluff attack for them. But they may... I assume they drop a wizard here. Yeah, nice little... Nice bluff attack here. So they have something. I'm going to assume it's rage. Yeah, because they would have played Diviner pre if they could have. So we'll just do this. Attack for 4. And play Arbor Mage, which I will gladly have eat a trick or whatever. And then we get... Oh, actually, we're not able to kick Colony yet because we need a second green source. So in that case, we will be on the Steel Bug Catcher plan, I suppose. Assuming they attack, use something to save it. Okay, Electro. Into Mystic. Wow, pretty scary. And now they're happy to trade. And I feel like I can't. So this is awkward, because if I draw a forest, I will have wished that I traded. But if not, then I have nothing else to do with my turn. So now... I'm going to attack with the ooze. They're down to 1 card. They played this tapped, which doesn't tell us much. And we'll steal the bug catcher. Falconer. Oof. Now we get 6 in the air. Yeah, this is a toughie. Don't think we have the goods here to come back. That ain't it. Yeah, all right. So flying is good and limited. You saw it here first. All right, here we are for game number 5, right? We're 3-1. And I think we're unfortunately gonna have to ship this back. If we had a green source here, we could definitely keep it, but this hand needs both lands and spells, and specific lands as well, so. It's gonna be a mulligan, and we get to keep this. So I will do so, and send back what? I feel like it's either Royal Mage or Domination. Domination is just too good, I think. We've got plenty of cheap plays for the moment, so I think I'll take the Royal Mage. And we're immediately presented with a pretty interesting decision, and I think I'm gonna choose to play the Florahedron on 2 rather than as a land. Now this has some risk associated with it. If we don't draw a third land and this is killed, we're in big trouble. But the upside, I think, is too high. All right, there's a sellsword from our opponent, and we're just gonna slam our Lull Mage's Familiar. Ooze would also be interesting, but I think getting the Familiar down is too important, especially with us missing land drops. I have a Knight Hawk Scavenger. Well, hopefully eventually I can steal that. So I can just kick this colony right now. And so I shall. One more land to steal the scavenger. What is this? Powers equal to 1 plus the number of card types among cards in your opponent's graveyard. Okay. And Thirst the 4/4. That's fine. Land. Nice. All right. Stealing the scavenger. 1, 2, 3. And then we can get it back. Rinse, repeat. Domination with Royal Mage is so good. Wow. Large and in charge, 7/5. Okay. Let's kick this. Is that better than 3-drop, 3-drop here? Maybe not. Because this I can't steal. My plan is to offer a trade. And maybe 3-drop, 3-drop is better. Here we go. You got a final or deadly alliance or whatever. Feed the swarm. Any number of removal spells. Okay. Protector means they can attack with the Colossus once. I'll take 7. Feels bad, but I'll do it. I think I still need the 05 on blocks. Now I can at least double block the Colossus if they have a way to kill Scavenger. We'll be in the market for stealing Celebrant, I think. Yeah, binding the scavenger, fine. Mm-hmm. Well, I don't need to do this. I could just play Cobra. I've got good blocks. And I can even hold the disruption. But I probably should play it to be able to steal a CMC4. I think we can give him a turn to potentially tap out. Kick a Gloom Hunter, as I keep hoping for. Shepherd, so close. So close. All right, so now I'm definitely gonna have wished that I played a land. Although an untapped land lets me do it because of Cobra. Right, 1, 2, 3, yeah. So we just do this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Locker Predation. So now they know about disruption. Yeah, do this. Whatever. And attack with Shepherd. Going pretty well, I'd say. Kapira Outrider does enable an attack for our opponent. Probably chump with the Florahedron. Okay. I don't think there's a reason to, well. I guess we play land. Thinking about Mind Drain. But I'm gonna hold back the 3/4 so that I have blocks. I guess I still had blocks on basically everybody. It doesn't quite feel like I'm stable. Whoa, 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 whoa. Opponent, please. Ooh, that's nice. pick up one. And I guess play it. And attack with Shepherd. Start getting Arbona down to a reasonable life total, hopefully. They're having some trouble with that that attack all button. Gain two, pull out a couple lands. And I think attack, what are their blocks if I attack? I think attack here. Oh, actually, no, I should have maybe left back Shepherd and gotten him with the Riptide. That was a mistake for sure. But if they're double trading, that's a good spot for me to be in. Just wish I had attacked with the Riptide instead. Alright, kick it. And attack. Nice. I think it's safe with them being at 9 mana to play the Disruption as a land at this point. Alright, got there. 4 wins. Alright, game number 6 here. We will keep on the play. Probably just setting up a couple critters early and draw some cards and see where that gets us, you know? Kazandu Valley early, wow, okay. I would imagine that means our opponent's hand is quite land light. Green white root grazer, yikes. All right, I'm just gonna hold up Disruption here if I can. Gosh. You know what's so sick is I can just put a basic land into play to pay for this. Ugh, I hate this. I'm gonna try it and hope that my land light read was correct, but that's so nasty. I mean, I don't know if I'm supposed to try and hope they don't have a land there or what, but there we go. All right, probably just Royal the Root Grazer. Try and draw into a second green source here. I mean, Jerboa Root Grazer is very scary. Very, very scary. Raptor Pickup Valley. Raptor Pickup Plains to replay Root Grazer. All right, so they get a nice double spell turn here. Yikes. Close, very close. I think we have to field research here. Try and get to... Oh, thanks a lot, Auto Tapper. Wow, that's so brutal. I guess I should have thought of that. Thought about our one reclaim. Actually, I really should have done that period because there's a very real chance I would have wanted to just play Colony as well, if we had drawn an island. Scale the Heights of the Raptor and you get to make another land drop? Maybe I was wrong, they were not land light. This is a huge attack. Devastatingly so. No blocks. Wow, and another one. They've got a really good version of this deck, obviously. And we do not. All right, scoop them up here. Too far behind, I think. Maybe if I had left up green last turn, we could have had a chance, but on the ropes. All right, here we go. I go first. That is a keeper. And what green cards might I want to play on two? Cobra, I guess. And it's not really ramp because I'm going to play this on three anyway. So I'm just going to drop Florahedron now. Okay. Guess we miss out on the No, we don't even miss out on the potential because I would have played a tapped here too. Anyway. All right. So we'll start with Familiar. Actually, it's possible that Riptide is just better there. Riptide, Royal. That's tempting. Yeah, maybe that was better. Base camp in blue black, huh? Mucklord. Sure. Hopefully we're gonna get some tempo here. Though we could have, in theory, already started that party. Relic Amulet. All right, well this is a party here. So we will kick this. Relic Amulet and Ghoul Draws Mucklord. Not cards you often see in the same limited deck. I wonder if it's just pausing because of Relic Amulet. Mucklord is back. Well, what's better? Feels like this is better. Make him block. Get another body on the board. Disruption? Oh, Anticog. Huh. All right. Wow. Brutal. How dare. Okay. Mine. And we can bounce this with Royal as well. All right, Diviner. Wow, gets up to three. Your move. Don't really feel like doing something there into open mana to get blown out. Like, Inscript. What does this do? What is? Can I read these or not? This is very annoying. I don't understand why I can't read this card right now. It's just destroy it and then I discard two, right? Destroy it, discard two. Do I want to royal this? No, I'll just royal this. Resolve. Discard Might and Royal. Hope for a forest here. But of course, why would we have one? And Royal back Domination, probably. I guess I Royal back into the Royal to get my loops going. I'll probably just get back Domination. And hold land for Mind Drain purposes. Okay, there's Amulet. There's Salundi Vision. I just get to kill Royal Mage. It's annoying. Salundi Vision whiffed, though, so that's good. All right, well, I'm glad I didn't get into the Royal. Hey, Inscription of Abundance. I guess I'm just playing this, huh? Where are my forests at? Wow. Okay. Muck Lord, fine. Into the Royal, bounce Muck Lord. Pretty good. I was mocking the Muck Lord deck. But now, all right, that's nice. Hopefully this is just a W next turn, but they didn't just top deck removal. Okay, muckety muck. Let's go. I guess I don't need to fight. I'm trying to figure out what would make that bad for me. And apparently it's nothing. So that's a W for us. 5-2. Alrighty, I go first. Well, I can play Arbor Mage, but I think this is a needs lands and spells type of hand. So I'm gonna mulligan this. Keep this and get rid of Stomper. It's not unexciting. This could be our downfall, folks. Fireblade Charger, you say? All right. It's a third land, but I get to blank this with Arbor Mage, whereas, let's see if they have a equipment. Okay, my turn. So let's drop this as a 2/3. Electromancer, float 2. And Channeler, wow. Yeah, that's a start. That is a start. Okay, we'll see if we can't get them with disruption here. Keep having trouble finding my second green source. Gosh, Channeler is so good. Yeah. Discard land, find Royal Eruption, oofta. Still block, I think. Do I get a 2-drop? No, I don't. How rude. I want to get a 2-drop. And this is sort of a big weakness of our deck. Like, you look at something like Channeler. I mean, I guess my way to get that off the battlefield is to steal it with Domination. Another Charger. And nothing? What? I guess I just do this because I can play Geyser Mage next turn. Of course, they'll have Mind Drain here. Can you tell I've been Mind Drained a lot? That's all I think about. They didn't activate Channeler either. Huh. Discarded Cinderclasm, okay. And they're attacking with Charger, no fear. So that means my guess is. Oh, wow. So let's Geyser Mage, I think, first. And get Channeler back up into their hand. Shatterskull Minotaur, okay. Yeah. Block Pack Beast. Kick Colony. Nice that we don't have to tap Familiar here. We'll offer this trade. Oh boy. If it's +3/+2, I'll have wished that I double blocked, I guess. I think I'm just blocking like this. Feels like it's +3/+2. Yeah. Okay. Well, hopefully this field research can draw us into some stuff. Ooh, or that. 7 cards in their graveyard. So I'll start with field research, I guess. Kick it, draw 3. That's it, those are all good draws, we accept those. I'm 2 spells away from Channeler being a 4/4 for me. Mace on the Charger. Okay. So take 8. But I don't think I'm in a bad spot right now. So I'm just going to play Riptide and pass. Nothing like playing Riptide and passing with 4 mana up, you know? Nothing to see here, opponent. Big Blade. On on the charger again. Yeah, I'll take the opportunity here to just kill the channeler and I'll bounce charger. Gain two. Riptide's a 5/5. That went well. And now they've got these two expensive re-equips while they're stuck on four lands. We are able to steal this for six. They play a bug catcher. Okay. So I think we're on the steal. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And no attacks. So they can mace. But that'll just be a 3-2 that we can block. They can put the blade on it, which we can then still block. They can charger, put the blade on it, we still block. So, and we're about to be off to the races in terms of Royal Mage and then re-steal something. And that re-steal something is looking like Sneaking Guide. Which if we draw a land, we can nab. Sneaking Guide kind of awkward with the mace. Although mace now gives it +2/+0. So now mace, if they want to equip an attack, we can still kill it, but then they get to kill the familiar. Oh, but they don't have the mana for it. So then it's about blade, so +2/+2, but they're just gonna be on charger here. Okay. So I can't Royal Mage and Domination on the same turn. I still think I'm supposed to do this though. Just make sure I'm not like gonna be dead to, you know, unblockable nonsense or whatever. They can make this unblockable, put a mace on it, and then attack with charger. I think I probably have to try and swing things back for myself here. I think we do this. Royal Mage, get back. I could also just get back into the Royal here. Considering how mana hungry they are, maybe that's just better. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. I'm just getting back into the Royal. And now I'm gonna attack with these two. They probably chump with charger to shoot the Royal Mage. Mm-hmm. That's fine. Resolves. Wow. Such as five, which I think is worth just straight up bouncing this. Oh no, I couldn't have done it. Oh, wow. That's just game, basically, right? It's almost. If I had another green source, I could ooze, and that would actually factually be game. But let's just go Sentinel. Attack for 10. Leave familiar back for good measure. Yep. Couple of bugs. And let's just go ooze, counter on the Sentinel, and we win. Don't even have to show him inscription. Nice. All right. That's. Win number six, we're getting maximum games here, going to game 9. All right, here we are for game number 9. We go first. This hand isn't great, but it's a keep. Hopefully we can find land number 3 on time and maybe just snowball out of control with Orin Refuse, depending on what our opponent has. But if we don't hit lands, this hand is gonna stumble quite a bit. All right, opponent mulls to 6. Island go. Plains. Oh, all right. I'm gonna play this tapped. It's a great spot for that cleric's deck in the finals, I see. All right, who's down? Counter on itself, let's go. Hope for no Feed the Swarm or Vanquish. Or Binding, I guess. Celebrant, fine. So they're gonna gain and attack, I would assume. But maybe not. Now, I think because we have Domination in hand, I'm okay to let this grow. This is actually very tough. Racing this deck is, you know what? Yeah, I'm gonna actually block. I'm just gonna get it off the battlefield. I feel like that's my best shot to deal with it early. I'm gonna not, I almost think I'm just not playing anything this turn. Maybe I play a colony. But the 2/1s do nothing. And I guess if I had a second green source, I think I would, but as has been the theme, second green has been tough for us. Okay, they play Rogue, tapped, and play Blight Priest. They've got the Wombo combo, so we need to find land number 6, 5 and 6, to mess with this. So I guess I'm going to Royal back the Priest. Trying to hit lands. There we go. All right, so if we can, I mean, if we go untapped 6 land next turn, and do an alternating steal something, get back domination, steal something, get back domination, steal something. That could be a pretty dang good recipe for a W. So I'm gonna steal Celebrant. And then I think attack with Colony. Very interesting to see if they have, they must have Blood Beckoning, would be my guess. Dreadworm, wow. That's very scary. Welp, I think I'm still just gonna do this. No attacks, because what we can do is play Cobra next. If we draw a land, we can Cobra next turn, and then a land drop will allow us to steal Dreadworm. And we'll have taken 10 along the way, but the other option is to play Colony, which forces them to play out their land drops, which I think they are light on, given that they played this tapped. Kite Sail, wow. Okay, Kite Sail is scary. So take 5. There's Reclaim. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Kick it. Boop, boop. Cobra. Still play land drop just in case. Cobra down. And I wonder if I should just play Colony. Kind of think yes. I don't know, maybe that's wrong. Gains us life right away. Hopefully no Mind Drain. The theme of this video. Thwart. Makes sense. Yeah. Wow, that's terrifying. So it wasn't Blood Beckoning, but it does make sense why they were okay to trade off so much earlier. This is gonna be difficult. Alright. Blue, let's steal the Dreadworm. No attacks, because I can't get through the Cleric. Smite the Dreadworm, fine. To the skies with the Blight Priest. Can't steal something this turn. I mean, I could bounce the kite, I guess, to kill something. So I at least threaten to do that. Okay, do I have flyers in the deck? I have Skyclave Sentinel, I guess. Whoa, that's their third Blight Priest. Holy cow, that's so much damage. Oh boy, this is tough. Oh boy. Okay, let's kick the research, see what we can't find. Arbor Mage? That doesn't do it. So we're basically dead to them playing a creature at this point. No, not quite, because we can play Riptide and land Florahedron, so we'll gain land Florahedron. They have a 4/4. It's a scary deck from the opponent. Very scary. Go to 3. Maybe they have nothing. Even so, weird. Well, okay. Green. Arbor Mage kicked. All of your creatures have to block Riptide. Next. Attack with just Riptide so that I can multi-block the Cleric if need be. Okay. I'm not dead yet. I think I might go for a walk. Okay. Block, block, block. Like, do we really think they've got a, they could have removal? That's the only, I doubt they have +2/+2, which this also plays around. So yeah, maybe we get rid of Cobra finally. Keep a Royal Mage in case we draw what, one more into? Yeah, okay, so I'll do it like that. If we draw a kicker spell here, we might not be dead. Land? Nothing. Okay. I think we just might be doing okay here. What a comeback this would be if we could win. Holy cow. Vanquish the familiar. Fine. So they did have a removal for it. All right, let's attack all. So the triple block was smart. We would have gotten blown out there. And it's just a shadow cat. That's fine. I mean, I can't really attack through that effectively other than the colony, but... And boy, howdy, has this core celebrant been making a difference for us. So we'll do just the cat. Now, if I attack all, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. No, it's not worth it. So we'll just do this. We just gotta hope they brick. It looks like they did. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So they block 1, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then 4, 5, 6. So it would be lethal over 2 turns if they have nothing. I think we say yes to that. Uh-oh. Wait, what? Okay. Fingers crossed. Looks like there's something. Wow, that changes the clock quite a bit. They can sack another creature to put a counter on it, so now it's a 2-turn clock if they want it. But that would kill them. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Whoa, I wonder what the last card is. It's making them think so much. It's terrifying. Mousing over my graveyard too? No, thank you. All right, they don't think they have an attack, which is very good for me. So we'll just attack with colony, I believe. Yeah, just attack with colony. They can double block. Oh, they've got... No, still could just be the Shadow Cat. Oh, wow. No attacks, no blocks. All right. And Nahiri's binding on the colony. That's brutal. Get in for 3. Colony's good. So I think we jam to get in an extra 2. They eat the Royal Mage, they take 2. Seems worth it. Colony kicked, we gain an extra life, meaning we're not dead to them sacking a creature there. We currently have lethal on attacks if they have nothing. I guess that's not true. Not true, because they can go block, block, and then sack. Oh, and then that happens. And then that happens. Well, I'm sure I missed some damage early on in the game where I could have, didn't think it was gonna come down to this, but it looks like it has. We're gonna get in for 3. Really exciting last game for sure. The attendant healer is just ridiculous. And land. Oh my god. What does that do? That's just gotta be game in some way, right? think if we attack all, there's just got to be a way for us to maneuver it to be lethal. Just a perfect circle here of pack one, pick one, Inscription of Abundance, and it being the last spell we cast in our ninth game. Could it be? This is a game if they triple block like this. So they're going to activate to give the cleric lifelink. Yeah, I don't think any of this matters. So we just to make sure that we go plus two here. And then have... Right, that just doesn't matter because I can sack. Yeah, so. Cast with kicker. Boop, boop, boop. Two counters here. Target player. And. Creature. Creature? Shadow Cat? Yeah. And I think that's good. Right, they can make the cleric, have lifelink, they'll gain one, but then they'll take three. So I think we're Gucci. Look at those colorful arrows there. Yeah, so they give that lifelink, that doesn't matter. They sack something, maybe? Not sure. Sure. Oof. So good. I did not think we were going to win that game. That was a very, very exciting game. All right. Got them 7 W's. Went from, what, 212 mythic-ish to 74? That's pretty decent. Someone wanted me to wait for the video to end to show the final get those 7 wins, but Arena's having a bit of a hard time. But thanks, everyone, for watching. I really, really appreciate it. There it is. Ba-ba-bam. Ba-ba-boom. There it is. And catch you next time.